Well, thank you for joining me and welcome to the Speak It app review. My name is West and I'm looking forward today to taking you through an awesome app. What I love about this app is it enables me to convert text into speech. Now, I've been using this app for a while now and it just gets better and better. This is the screen that it comes up with when you first enter into the app. I'm going to give you a really quick tour and then I'm going to show you how I use it to leverage my time, which I'm excited to tell you about. This particular window here, once I tap in it, comes up with a flashing dot. Now, if you want to type in text to convert into speech, you can feel free to do that. I already have a body of text attached to my clipboard, which I'm gonna just tap and paste. So I'm just gonna go ahead and paste the text here. And when I hit speak it, I want you to just turn the volume up here. I want you to listen to what this app actually does.
You know, the phrase property development sure can cover a lot of ground. I'm not just talking about commercial, industrial, residential, etc., but the little niche markets that you sometimes stumble across. Within the residential market, there are areas of specialization such as student accommodation, service apartments.
So we won't go through the rest of that, but you pretty much get what this app does. It just reads text really clearly and accurately for you. Now, just a few things before we move on with how to actually use it. You can actually choose out of four, this particular version, four different voices, American voices or British voices, male and female. I like the Heather, the American female voice. I think it's the best one out of the four. But you know, you can choose depending on what you want to do. Now, the other beautiful thing about this app is when I go ahead and tap the settings button up here, it allows me to adjust a few things. The first thing is the font size. If you want to read it as you go, you can adjust the font size to higher or lower. The volume of the voice, obviously, higher or lower. You can also use your iPhone settings to adjust the volume of the voice. But here's the thing that I love, and that is the speed of the voice. Now, I love listening to audio sped up. I can get to about 2 to 3 times at the moment and not lose too much comprehension. Love my speed listening, and this is a great way and a fantastic app in order to do that. Really impressed by it. So by speeding this up to a higher setting, if we go and listen to this recording again, it should go a lot faster.
You know, the phrase property development sure can cover a lot of ground. I'm not just talking about commercial, industrial, residential, etc., but the little niche markets that you sometimes stumble across. Within the residential market, there are areas of specialization such as student accommodation.
So how cool is that? That's pretty awesome. Now, when you paste a body of text in the Speak It app, it then gives you the option by tapping this arrow here to either save it in the app in order to read it to you later, or create an audio file which you can email to yourself and edit it or use it however you like. So it's a very, very improved option on the previous version, which didn't allow you to, it allowed you to do it, but you had to pay per credit. So all credit to Speak It for improving that. And I think it's pretty sensational feature. So here are, for example, a few samples of text that I've saved, which can be read out later at any time. And if I just scroll here are some audio files that I've created, and it creates it in the .AIFF format, which can be played once you've saved it to your email. So huge implications for leveraging information products in this app, and many other ways, which I'll take you through now. So the first thing I like to use this for is by reading my emails when I'm on the go, or I'm driving, or when my body is busy but my mind is free. So when I'm cooking or when I'm doing anything that I can actually, my mind is free to listen to stuff, I'll go ahead and copy, the latest batch of emails, paste them in and save them, and then I can just play them all while I'm doing stuff, which is awesome to have your emails read out to you. Now, another cool little tip is I actually have a little microphone that I carry around with me that I just plug into the iPhone jack and turn up the volume, because the iPhone microphone isn't all that loud. And, you know, no matter where I am, if there's noise levels, I can still hear it pretty well. So it's a great way to save time, and it's a great way to just, you know, power through your messages real quick. The second way I like to use this app is by reading websites and articles, great articles that I come across when I'm surfing Safari on the iPhone. I might come across a great blog post that I read, say, for example, Tim Ferriss's site. He's always got good stuff. I'll just copy it and paste it in here and have that read to me while I'm doing stuff for later. So I don't actually have to sit there and scroll through and read it at the moment. Same with ebooks, any PDF documents or Word documents that I've been sort of meaning to read. I can paste extracts, chapters, and have it read to me. I'm not actually sure what's the limit of how much text you can actually paste in here. I'll have to test that out and leave a comment after this video. At this point, it definitely takes a good chunk of text without having too much problems. And I also like to create audio files to put on my MP3 player if it's something important. So let's say it's a series of articles that I've been meaning to read for a long time. I'll save it as audio and then convert it and put it onto my MP3 player, which I can read later. Another way you could use this is to convert any ebooks you might have written into an audio version. And, you know, a lot of people don't have the time to sit down and read all of their text into an audio and record it professionally. Being a audio listener, much preferred over reading, I'll take a robotic type voice over reading it any day of the week, because it means I'll at least get it read. Having said that, the voices here are pretty damn good. Compared to it, text-to-speech has come a long, long way in the past. These voices are pretty good, I have to say. So in terms of improvements, I mean, I was listening to Text Aloud, one of the Text Aloud voices of late, and that voice blew me away with how realistic and real life it was. So I think for future improvements, SpeakIt can integrate even more lifelike voices, but overall, you know, I think this app is it's pretty awesome, and I use it a lot, and I think it saves me a lot of time and hassle, and I love the fact that it can speed up audio. So I'm going to give this app an 87% out of 100. It's a must-have app, and in my opinion, something that will definitely be able to help you leverage your time and your productivity. So thanks for listening, and we'll see you in the next app review.